How dare you? They gave you peace. I want you to remember that they gave you peace. And you said no. Why? Or because you were scared. Fear is a great thing. Fear is a superpower. But with great power comes great responsibility. And you blew that. I hope you know you blew that. I can't help you two now.
Doctor, what do you mean? It wasn't fair. You should have stopped them. You could have saved them.
They had it coming.
But if everyone thought like that, no one would be safe. No one.
I didn't save them anyway. If we got involved, they would have killed us. We are lucky they didn't kill us anyway.
How dare you? Never say you couldn't save them. You didn't even try. You could have reasoned with the Ice Warriors and then they could have been punished for it in some sort of way. Death should never be the option. It's wrong. It's immoral.
Sometimes all the options you have are bad ones. You just have to choose the lesser of two evils.
Don't you dare. Don't you dare talk to me in riddles like I'm a kid. Like I'm a child. No one on Earth, no one on this universe should have the power to decide if death is the worst option. Death is the worst option. There's no lesser evil, there's just cowardness.
How dare you argue with me? We are going to the TARDIS and you are going straight home.
Just for speaking up? For speaking up against your morals?
For undermining my decisions.
Do you know what? Forget it. I'd much rather go home than do this. You're evil, you're wrong, and you should never be trusted. It's not about showing people the universe, is it, Doctor? It's about placing your moral code on them. Now take me home, and then fly away in your sad, lonely box and never come back. You should leave Earth alone, as no one should ever do that. No one should ever watch something die just because they did something wrong.
Hello, this is the Unified Intelligence Task Force recording. I'm Officer Smith. Sorry, first day on the job. Last person was killed by a Zygon. Ugh, enough about that. Anyway, this is the file on Stacy Roberts. As you know, it's protocol to record all of the Doctor's companions' journeys the minute they choose to either return home or unfortunately are deceased. This is file 1 of 2 for Stacy Roberts, as this is the time she chose to turn home. It's an odd one, I know. No one really knows what went on, only her and the Doctor. Because everyone else in the incident was killed. Rumour states that Stacy had enough of something the Doctor had done, so she went home. But I think that's where this file becomes strange. This story is interesting at this point, because Stacy goes home, but she doesn't stay for very long.
Oh, Stacy, where have you been? Stacy, what's wrong?
The Doctor. I went travelling with him, and I saw some incredible things, but I saw death. And I couldn't do it anymore. He believed death was a better option than trying to save someone.
He may have been trying to save you.
I just thought he must have seen so much death. How does he sleep?
Hey, listen. I told your gran you've been living with me for a week, as I assume you went with the Doctor.
Is that how long I've been gone? A week?
Yeah. Now come on, let's get you home.
George, it's Gran.
What's wrong? Please, Stacy, tell me.
I should have been here. I should have stayed with her. I shouldn't have run off. I remember what her New Year's resolution was going to be as well. She wanted to take up dancing, ballroom dancing. She said there was this club at the centre of the Fleet Street for the older people. was so much going that she wanted to do. Grandad, how am I going to tell him? Will he come to the funeral? I don't have enough money for the funeral. Or Grandad's home. Where am I going to live? I have nothing. Absolutely nothing.
Hey, you can stay with me as long as you need, and the rest we can figure it out together.
We? There's no we about it. It's not you that's happened to. It's me. Just me. Sorry. I didn't mean to snap at you.
It's okay. Should we get something to eat?
Can't eat. Can't do anything. I need to tell Grandad.
Stacy, I'm always here for you. I'm always here for you, and I'm never not going to be. Is that understood?
That's the day she found out her Grandad died. She's been travelling around time and space. She's only been gone a week. Never told her. Never said goodbye to her. Because you never do you? You never notice that the last day of someone is their last until it's over. Everything's a last of something, but you never know it. I think it broke her. I think it mentally broke her. All she had left now was her Georgian granddad. And I think her granddad was the reason she ran away again. Not quite yet. Still one more thing that happened first.
2 weeks ago, I lost my grandma. And now everyone thinks I'm okay. But the truth is, I'm far from okay. My name's Stacy Roberts, and this is my life. A life that has recently changed. My life was turned upside down. It's become full-on action and adventure and death, but also wonder. But I also valued life of strangers, even if they did wrong. This made me lose a new friend, the doctor. Now all I have is George and Grandad, and I'm living life and I can't get used to it. Except this isn't living. Every day is the same. I get up and get ready for school or work, the same as everyone else. But yet, I'm not the same. I go to school and everyone's doing the same old thing. Taking selfies, bullying, laughing, maybe even crying. People around me talking about homework and Netflix, but I can't connect to anything. 2 weeks ago, my grandma died. And they think I'm fine. They're wrong.
Do you want to go out tonight?
Where?
We can go Nando's. How about Wetherspoons? Or that new milkshake place around the corner from Toys R Us?
I'm not sure we should.
To be honest, there's someone I want to show to you.
Who?
Well,
when you're away, I got a boyfriend.
Oh, congratulations! I guess we can go to that milkshake place if it means that much to you.
I can text him to meet us there, and I will get you your milkshake.
Good. I have no money.
Come on then.
The invasion of Flint's.
This is now our land. We will not kill all humans. We will not kill all humans. We will not invade all countries. We will not invade all countries. Let us have the country known as England, and we will not destroy this planet. If anyone is human, we will invade this piece of rock and take by force. My army will invade England now, and from this moment on, England belongs to the Flints. It is human, and we will be eradicated.
Stacy is one of the bravest companions the Doctor's ever had. They all are. They're all exceptional human beings everyone has ever travelled with. From Rose to Liz. From Sarah to Joe. From Leela to Lucy Miller. They're all incredible companions. They always have been, they always will be. But if you scrap them from everything, you find it hard to cope. The Doctor wouldn't be able to destroy the universe without his sonic screwdriver and his TARDIS and his friends. Even could Stacy. She was stuck, but she did what she knew was right, and that was make sure she could get her granddad and George safe. That's when the Doctor came back.
Come on, Grandad, we need to go.
What's going on? You're a nurse. She left.
Come with me. We haven't got much time.
What is that?
Grandad, get back! I'm glad to see you.
Can't leave the human race alone for 5 minutes. Come on, into the TARDIS.
Grandad, come on.
The invasion of Flint wasn't a hard battle. It wasn't at all. But they won. They still won. It's a victory, nevertheless. Don't know what the Doctor did. He did something on the Flint command ship, I believe. Most of our files on the Doctor are quite empty, truth be told, but nevertheless, he's a good man and saves people. So does Stacy.
Determines a number of probabilities. It calculates everything. This plan has been carefully calculated by the brain, and the probability will be successful. And for it to be successful, it must be 80%.
90%.
How come it has increased?
We felt 80% was inefficient.
Go on then. Tell us your plan.
We invaded London for one thing, and that's target practice. We simulated an invasion on Earth to see how London would react. Our invasion tactic is to see how multiple level 5 planets respond, and nearly all of them run and hide. Nothing is done.
Invading a level 5 planet is against galactic rule.
But if we invade Kallek out in the Golbeck galaxy, we have a 92% chance of success.
Just leave Earth alone. Now.
Or what? What could you do?
I'm the Doctor. I could do anything. Why don't you reassess the situation and then make your decisions?
Well, that was true.
Shut up and get back to the TARDIS.
And then after that, who knows what happens? I know George ends up in the TARDIS. We all do. He's got his own file. Maybe it's linked to Stacy's second file, I don't know yet, but we'll decide that closer to the time. Sorry, you weren't meant to see that. Yes, now you know what's about to come.